Yes, the ACR meeting this year was a virtual meeting because of the COVID pandemic. The COVID pandemic is changing our way in which we are doing meetings, and of course it's changing our approach to the patients, because we know that we, particularly during this time, we need to reduce any risk for the patients. And in Italy, we had a lot of cases, and we introduced in our practice many changes for protecting patients, but also for protecting doctors and nurses from the risk to have the COVID, the coronavirus infection. The EACR meeting this year was a particular meeting because of the way in which the meeting was done, so only virtual. But even with this restriction, the meeting was very interesting, with many important presentations. And of course, some of the presentations were focused specifically on the COVID pandemic. Some experience, particularly experience conducted in Italy, were presented. It was a very nice paper presented by Dr. Ascerto, and another interesting paper that was presented by Marina Garassino. It was a collection of information in patients with lung cancer with COVID. And also, of course, we had many other relevant presentations on the efficacy of new therapies in the field, specifically of lung cancer, and focusing specifically in lung cancer. So I selected the session on target therapies and immunotherapy, and I selected specifically three papers that I think were very interesting. One was the Zenith 20 trial. That was a clinical trial with poziotinib. Poziotinib is a very interesting drug targeting exon 20 mutation in EGFR and also in HER2 genes. The data that were presented during the ACR were data on the cohort of patients with EGFR mutations already pretreated. This analysis also included patients with brain metastasis. And the data of this trial were less encouraging compared to previous presentations, because the response rate in this trial was only 14%, with a median progression-free survival of 4.2 months. So data that probably were less exciting than the initial data presented in a monocentric trial. In addition, this trial also confirmed that poziotinib is not an easy drug, with approximately 78% of patients needing dose reduction. So that means that the drug is not easy to give to the patients, and there is a risk, a potential risk of adverse events. The other important trial was the Geometry trial. This is a very interesting trial because it's focusing in a specific group of patients that have non-small cell lung cancer with MET deregulation. And data that were presented were specifically in patients with MET mutation. And also this study included patients with also with brain metastasis. It's important to highlight that probably in this trial, the population that was included was not the typical population of MET mutated or MET deregulated, because generally we consider MET deregulated patients as patients with a relevant exposure to cigarette smoking. But in this study, approximately 60% of patients were never smoking. So in some way, probably the patients were selected. In this trial, response rate was very encouraging. It was approximately 40% in pretreated patients and up to 60% in untreated patients, with also evidence of efficacy on the brain. This is an important trial, an important data with capmatinib, indicating that we have now drugs potentially effective in this group of patients that is absolutely not easy to treat. We have to remember that MET deregulated patients are generally patients with a very bad prognosis. So this is an important message that we have from this trial. So probably we have a drug giving a drug that is effective specifically in this group of patients. And the third trial I selected was on immunotherapy. So the data that were presented on the role of two mutations, the STK11 and the KEAP1, in patients treated with pembrolizumab monotherapy. These two mutations are very relevant because there are several reports suggesting that presence of mutations in this gene could in some way modify response to immunotherapy. In the analysis that was presented during the meeting, the incidence of this mutation was 7% for STK11 and 15% for KEAP1 mutations. Importantly, the two mutations could be present at the same time, so we had some patients also displaying, harboring both mutations. And importantly, the effect, the efficacy of pembrolizumab versus chemotherapy in this study was completely independent of presence of these mutations. So is the message that we have from this trial is that these two mutations probably are not really useful in selecting patients candidate for immunotherapy or at least for pembrolizumab, because the drug is effective irrespective of the status of these two genes. I think these are among the most interesting trials and news that were presented during the AACR.